I had the pleasure of joining Goodwill in 2012. It was an opportunity to step out of the corporate world and into a world of inspiration. A lot of companies are in a position of creating opportunity for shareholders. Our relationship is very tight and very intimate with the community. With Goodwill being a social enterprise very much focused on business, it was an opportunity for me again to combine all worlds, that of service, of charitable intent, philanthropy, but through, again, a very robust social enterprise. Every day is a day of inspiration. Every day somebody with a disability is given an opportunity they didn't have the day prior. That is incredibly inspiring.
Thank you for supporting our mission.
Goodwill began in 1902 in Boston. A Methodist minister by the name of Edgar J. Helms saw opportunity. He saw in the wealthier parts of Boston household goods being discarded and therefore going to waste. What he did is he saw the opportunity for creating employment and better tomorrows for people of disadvantage in Boston. So through the discarded household goods, he created two opportunities. One, the mending and repair of those discarded items, which created employment. And then through resale, the early days of the thrift retail system, he created revenue and reinvesting back into the programs to create opportunities, employment, career development, life skill enhancement for people of disadvantage in Boston. Edgar J. Helms believed in a hand up, not a handout, for the reasons of that a handout is temporary. A handout is an artificial band-aid for a temporary circumstance. A hand up is creating capacity, wherewithal, and the opportunity to succeed from the perspective of that individual over time. Goodwill as an organization has existed to nearly 70 years in Alberta. The first store under the name of Goodwill opened in 1963 here in Edmonton. The official tartan of Alberta was sewn and produced by Goodwill about 50 years ago here in Edmonton. It was designed by Goodwill and then officially adopted by the province of Alberta as the tartan of Alberta, and has since then again been at the legislature and other prominent places of notoriety. In 1975, the opportunity existed to join the family of Goodwills across, again, North America and in the other countries. And so we were registered as a nonprofit charity here in Alberta, officially in the mid-1970s, to become Goodwill Industries of Alberta. Goodwill operates in 17 countries, the United States, Canada, into Central America, and recent additions including South Korea and Brazil. So there are 165 Goodwills in 17 countries. Collectively, the 165 Goodwills do over $5 billion a year of annual sales. All of that as nonprofit registered charities reinvested back into the community. So we're a collective of 165 inspiring social enterprises. The mission statement of Goodwill Industries of Alberta is that through a social enterprise, we are positively affecting lives through the creation of meaningful employment for Albertans with disabilities. Meaningful employment means not just short-term or band-aid employment, if you want to call it that. Through career development and job enhancement, we are creating careers, not just jobs. So the thread back to 1902 is still there in terms of creating opportunities through a hand-up, not a handout, through the power of a job. Today, we're much bigger, we're much more refined, we're into many lines of business. Many Goodwills are operating janitorial services, landscaping services. We have a wonderful commercial services division that is a unique employment vehicle here in Alberta, creating employment for people challenged with mental health disorders. We believe we're the only enterprise in Alberta with a dedicated division to that type of employment. So we've come a long way, but we've never forgotten about our tremendous roots back in 1902. Our heritage here in Alberta goes back nearly 70 years. We are one of seven Goodwills in Canada, but we're the only Goodwill in Western Canada. And we cover the landmass of Alberta. So we're a unique Goodwill in again, covering from border to border to border, the communities throughout Alberta. Many Goodwills in the east will hub around major centers. But we are, again, unique because we're the only one in Western Canada and we cover the borders of Alberta. Over 25% of our workforce are persons with disabilities. That's self-disclosed. We believe there are many, many more people with disabilities that have gravitated to our enterprise. So we are a very large employer of people with disabilities, but we also place through the Power of Work program hundreds of persons with disabilities in the community into great jobs on an annual basis. In 2014, Goodwill Industries of Alberta was able to invest over $19 million into providing opportunities for Albertans with disabilities through, again, our Power of Work program and creating employment for Albertans with disabilities. In 2014, team members with disabilities working at Goodwill earned over $2 million in wages, and that is a record for us. So it again is a very inspirational connection with the community because for the most part our donors and shoppers know what we do and what they're part of, and so therefore it's not just a Goodwill team, 500 team members, it's that of thousands of people across Alberta making a difference every day. In as much as we are an employment model, we are also a major recycler. We divert nearly 5 million kilograms of products that would have perhaps been destined for Alberta landfills. So in as much as we're proud of our achievements for creating employment opportunities, we're equally proud for our opportunity to be stewards of the environment and make such a difference here in Alberta. Hello, Denise.
Hi, Dale.
How you doing?
Good.
Our employees are tremendous. They are hardworking, they are inspired themselves, but they want to make a difference. And each one is an individual. We have over 500 team members, but we encourage, we promote that it's a very flavored interaction with our shoppers. We want the individualistic tendencies and the dynamic reasons for why people want to work at Goodwill to come out. We're not robots, we are not structured, we are professional, but we are very, we celebrate diversity. And we celebrate the fact that we're all in it together to create an opportunity for better tomorrows. Our family members, our Goodwillians, our team members really appreciate that opportunity. But they're not only earning a good wage working at Goodwill and getting skill development and training and other opportunities through a great working environment, they are part of a journey for persons with disabilities that they feel very, very good about. Not a lot of people in the workplace get to go to work, earn a wage, create relationships at work, but at the end of the day, know that they're part of something very, very special.
When I was in the interview process, I didn't really know too much about Goodwill, but after talking to Dale, our CEO, found out about our mission and all the great things that Goodwill does, it really made me say, hey, this is something that I could do to give back to the community. Goodwill's different from other companies, you know, because it's not just about the numbers and making money and all the rest of it. It's helping people with disabilities get meaningful employment. And that's what makes the difference. So we really treat everybody like a family. All the people are great. I work with a great group of store managers, a great executive team. Everybody is in it for the mission, but also trying to strive to do good for the community and also to make money, because we need to make money to support our mission. You can make a difference in somebody's life. You know, if you're having a bad day, you can come and talk to the people that are processing or in the store. They're so excited to be working at Goodwill, and you feel good by the end of the day.
Going today in collectibles.
Pretty good, and you?
Not too bad, not too bad. Wow, what have you got there?
It's an old trombone.
It looks like an old trombone. The donation area is our first point of contact with our donor, who's probably the most important person in our organization. Our donor attendant greets our donor, thank them for supporting our mission and bring the donation in, and then do a very preliminary quick sort of hard versus soft, as we call it. It's really the lifeblood of our company. Without donations, we don't have stores, and we don't have any money to support our mission of helping people with disabilities. We get over 8 million articles of clothing a year and over a million articles of hard goods. In a lot of ways, we are recyclers. We try to maximize the donation wherever we can. Whatever we cannot sell in the store, either we'll go up to our recycling center, where we try to either rebag it and send it back to be sold in the store, or be sent to a recycler where we're getting money to help support our mission, or going through our salvage to help third world countries with the product. Well over 3.7 million kilograms of goods are being diverted from our landfill. There are 21 donation centers throughout Alberta. Some of those are attached to a store, and some of those are conveniently located through neighborhoods throughout the province of Alberta. Satellite donation centers are what we call attended donation centers. They're actually feeders to our larger stores, so they would be feeding larger stores, and or in the summertime, product will be diverted into our warehouse, which will then be used at a later date. We have a transportation network that is going 7 days a week, 361 days of the year. We're only closed for 4 days out of the year. And they are always moving product from a store to a donation center to a warehouse, depending on the route and the time of the year. Our mission is all about providing meaningful employment for people with disabilities. Our goal is that a person comes in here, we train them to do certain things, either in processing, retail, and they may advance to another career with another company outside Goodwill. The donation attendant's role is primarily to meet our donor, thank them for supporting their mission, count the donor as a donor. Whether a donor brings in a truckload or whether they bring in one bag, it is counted as one. But we use that donor count to tell us where to put stores, where to put more donation centers. That's really the key metric that drives a lot of the business.
My name is Bradley Jones. I'm the donor attendant at the West End store, the best store in Alberta. I've been working at Goodwill for over 21 months, so almost 2 years. I have Tourette syndrome, obsessive compulsive disorder, Asperger's, and nonverbal learning disorder. I've been bullied my whole life ever since I was a little boy in kindergarten. And I also have major anxiety problems, and I have minor depression. I've been bullied for having disabilities and for acting different. There are people who disregard me and don't take me seriously and think they're better than me because I have disabilities. I'm dramatically different from when I started. It has helped me learn an initiative. It has helped me with my self-esteem, my confidence. It's taught me that I can achieve anything. It's basically broadened my horizons and expanded my limits so I can do more things than I've ever been capable of before. There was a time in my life where I had no self-esteem or confidence, and then I bounced back and went to good, and it's got even more good ever since I started. When I'm having a bad mood, I just talk to staff, and they generally can make me feel better. They give me a lot of joy and a lot of happiness, and I can go to work in not the best of mood, and I come out so happy because I know I've accomplished so much. It's a radically transformational workplace. It makes you into a better person than you came. One time a girl said to me that her father taught her to leave someone better than they found them. Well, that's what I like to do too. And while others do it for me, I like to do it for others too.
In processing is organizational chaos. There is a method to the madness. There are set processes that we do use to process the product. We have a saying, two to the floor in 24, so donations that are received today, the goal is to have them on the floor by the end of the day or first thing tomorrow morning. But as I say, in the summertime when things are seasonal flow because of our weather, it gets to be pretty chaotic what goes on in the organization. Every day is a different day. We do not know what's coming in the donation door on an hourly, a daily basis, so we don't know what we're selling 2 days down the road. And that's what makes it different. And when we get into our busy season in the summer, it's a bit of chaos because of the flow that comes through our donation centers. When it comes into the processing area, the goods are divided between what we call soft and hard goods. So soft is all your clothing, what we call textiles. That will go to a grading station, where it will be graded into five sorts: ladies, men's, children's, pants, and linens. Hard goods are broken down into five categories: accessories, books, toys, wares, glass, and audiovisual. Then they go to a pricing station where a pricer will take a look at the item, make sure it's saleable. If it's saleable, they're gonna put it into a bin system depending on the value of the goods, and then somebody else will, what we call tag and price. So they will tag the goods and put them on a cart so they get put out onto the floor. The soft goods are then going to go to a hanging station. So there's a bin full of, as I said, the five categories. Let's say it's ladies' wear. We'll go to what we call a hanging tagging station. We work off a color-coded system, so each week is a different color. They will attach a barb to it and hang it onto a rack ready for the floor. So product that's soiled or torn, depending on the product, we have a rag cutting program in our commercial services where we actually make rags and sell them in our stores and to other vendors in the Edmonton area. So they'll either be sorted into that or they'll be sorted for recycling. We're actually in the recycling business, so then all those goods will go up to a recycling operation where they will be baled and shipped offshore to our salvage vendors. Within processing, you have a donation attendant, you have pricers, you have graders, you have what we call hanger taggers, and then we have runners to the floor, which are basically taking the product out to the floor and actually rotating the product off. Up to about 20 to 30 people could be working in a processing area in a large store, and could be 10 to 15 people in our smaller stores. When a grader or pricer sees something that's really unique, we send that over to our collectibles department, okay? On our collectibles department, then we actually use a laptop and we go on the web to search out what a value is. That then goes to our collectible section, which is a monitor section by our cash registers where somebody will help you to look at the product and make a determination if you want to buy it. Books or records, they're sorted exactly the same way. We have different pricing structures for books, depending on whether it's a hardcover, softcover. We actually even do an annual art book fair. So if we do get some high-end first edition hardcover books, we will actually store them for the time frame and then put them out at a higher price in our art and book fair. LP, same thing. They're basically, but we do put them out and have a separate section for our LPs. Seasonal items we actually store. So we basically store Halloween and Christmas and other seasonal items such as winter coats. One of the interesting things is when people are donating in the winter, they donate at the end of winter their winter wear. So we'll put a few of those out just in case somebody wants them, but then we will store them in our warehouses, the seasonal product, and bring it back in at the time of the season.
I work for 3 years for Goodwill. I like working with people because it's a good team effort and they treat me great. They're like a family to us because it's a good company. It helps people with disability. I feel in love in Goodwill.
Hi, Kelsey.
I was approached by Dale Monahan. I think his passion for what Goodwill does is really what struck me, and understanding how much you can do by repurposing items and not just donating to a landfill, that you can actually take a shirt that you no longer wear, you can donate it to Goodwill. The profits from that then are used to help educate, empower Albertans with disability, train them in the workforce. And on a tour of Goodwill, I was fortunate enough to meet Kelsey Wood. And Kelsey was the other person I think that really made me choose to become involved with Goodwill as their ambassador.
What do you think?
Yeah.
You know, my role as ambassador, I think, is to be a voice. I think it's to be out in the community. It's to speak for Kelsey. It's to speak for all the individuals that Goodwill helps. It's to raise awareness and explain to people what Goodwill does. I think we have a lot in common. I think we both are passionate about whatever we do. So I watch her, and I watch her at work, and I watch the passion that she displays when she's working and how much she enjoys the people that she's around. And I watch what she does in sport, and I think I have that same passion. I love people, I love to help people, and I love to give a voice to those who can't, and I love sports. So I think her and I have a lot in common, and that fuels a really great relationship. We started talking about the Olympics because that's what we had in common. She's a Special Olympian and I'm an Olympian. So we started talking about what sports we did, and she was listing off all these sports, and she's like, you know, what do you do? And I said, well, curling. And I said, so how many medals do you have? And she goes, I have 6 or 7 medals. And she's like, how many do you have? And I said, oh, I just have one. And she kind of patted me on the back and she's like, that's okay, I can share some of mine. So.
I like these heart ones, look at these.
You know, I think Kelsey and I'll spend some time spreading the word together. We both have that same mindset and we both really want to make a difference and we want to speak for others, and we both have a lot in common, and I think that will put us on a really good path to go out there and spread the Goodwill word together.
Goodwill makes me feel exciting and it's important to me.
retails to the final process. After the donations come in and the goods are processed in the processing area, they come out onto the floor, and this is where the treasure hunt is and where the product is sold. The stores generate the revenue that help us support a mission of helping Albertans with disabilities have meaningful employment. We have just about everything. We have clothes, we have hard goods, we have, you know, have furniture, we have collectibles, we have jewelry, we have shoes, accessories, just about everything you want, and we have some very unique finds. You can even have a, you know, musical instruments, whatever somebody donates, we put it out on the floor. About 50% of your sales are your apparel sales. That's probably the biggest driver of the retail sales side. A larger store like the store we're in today is approximately 20 employees are on the retail floor. Smaller stores might only have about 8 to 10. From a store this size, we could have anywhere from 100 to 300 customers, and from a provincial wide basis, anywhere from 3,000 to 3,500 customers a day. We have 13 retail stores throughout the province and 3 centers in Edmonton, Calgary, and Grand Prairie. The key to the retail stores are clean stores, tremendous customer service, and a wide variety of product. We want the customer to have a fantastic experience. We want them to return over and over again for that treasure hunt. Well, the treasure hunt is there are unique products hidden throughout the store. We have a unique pricing system. We have what we call line pricing, so therefore a pair of jeans is $8, and you can find a high-end brand, Seven for Man, All Mankind, that may be $150 for $8, or you may find a Levi's brand for $8, and that's what it's all about. It's about the treasure hunt, and that's where we have a little bit of uniqueness over some of our competitors. Most retail stores, you go in, you're looking for something in particular, and the thrift shopping, a thrift shopper is looking for that find. So they will come in. We have customers come in every single day. We have customers come in 3-4 times a day. They are looking for that constant new find, because new product is coming on the floor on an hourly basis, and that's really what it's about. It's about the treasure hunt and the find to get that unique item at a very good price. We're on a color rotation system, so basically a product will stay on the shelf a maximum of 3 weeks. It's out at full pricing for the first 2 weeks, and then on the third week it'll go on sale at 50% off, and if there is anything left on that fourth week, it'll be taken off the shelves and sent to our recycling center. All the revenue from the store goes to fund our Power of Work program and stays in Alberta, help Albertans with disabilities have meaningful employment.
My name is Samantha Peters, and my position at Goodwill is doing the fitting rooms. I have been working with Goodwill for 18 months. I like it because I can socialize with the customers and I have wonderful staff. I was born 3 months premature. I weighed 929 grams and I struggled with fine motor skills, and I was diagnosed as legally blind when I was 4 years old. They have helped me become more self-confident and have assisted me in doing different things like putting away stock, putting away glasswares, doing the fitting rooms, tagging clothing, hanging clothing. I can see, I just have difficulty with distance. I use a magnifier and I also have help from my staff when I need it. My favorite part of Goodwill is working in the fitting rooms, helping the customers, and putting away stock, and putting away glasswares, and socializing with my coworkers and sales associates, and all that kind of stuff. Way happier than I was in school, for sure. Because I was always told to pay attention or do my job, or I was always told what I wasn't doing. So it was a constant put down, basically. I probably would be severely developmentally delayed if I didn't work. I probably would have a lot of difficulty if I didn't get to this point, that is. My self-esteem has been better since I started at Goodwill, because I'm no longer told, pay attention, do your job, or you're not doing good enough, or not being praised for stuff. Whereas now, all I hear is, I can do this, you can do the fitting room, you can do that.
I started working with Goodwill Industries of Alberta in September of 2014. I'm just learning more about Goodwill, learning about, it's not just about the donations, but everything that they do with the donations and moving forward with their mission excited me beyond belief to be part of such a great team. Goodwill is different in the respect that it's people. It's so people focused, and it's not just people within the communities that we can engage in. I've been on the corporate side, and I've been blessed with great corporate companies as well. The beauty of working with Goodwill is that everybody is going towards the same goal with the same mission. And it's not about necessarily what always happens inside your own office. It's about what occurs outside of your office. I always talk about making a difference, but I also always challenge people, let's be the difference. The more I learn about Goodwill and knowing what we're doing now, how we're doing it, but where we're going in the future, excites me a lot. Commercial Services is a division of Goodwill Industries of Alberta. It is a division that provides cost-saving and innovative ways for businesses to share with us and give us product and assembly line projects that we can do right here at Commercial Services for them, as opposed to having one of their staff members do it, that they can contract us out and we would do that project for them. We provide an environment that is structured and accommodating, and by doing so, we are able to have our primary focus with individuals with disabilities, more so with mental health challenges. It's by providing this environment that they are able to see more successes in their community of employment. They come here, they work on projects and contracts that we receive from the community, but they're able to do it within their hours that fit their schedule with everything else that they have occurring in their lives. For the businesses and the corporations and government out there, they're able to send us quotes on projects, and we would be able to achieve their goals to get a project done in a timely manner or into a long-term project that we can put into our schedule. Currently, with the products being produced at Commercial Services, we have our signature project, which is our cleaning cloth. I'm very proud to have that signature item that has occurred over the last many years. And that's part of the program of all the t-shirts and the towels that are not able to be sold in the stores and or have gone through the sale and the retail. They come over to us at Commercial Services, and we process them by sorting, and then they get cut into cleaning cloths, and we sell them in 20-pound boxes and or we roll them and sell them in 4 packages. And we sell them out to the community everywhere from oil field into car washes, into bakeries, and the list goes on with all of our customers. We also have a major telecommunications company that we do wire cutting for, and that's a 3-step process that we've engaged that contract for a while as well. And we're currently working on a project with canola seeds, and we're looking at a 10,000 sheet process on that. So we're quite excited to have those variations right now with us. In alignment with the rest of our mission of Goodwill, we have profit with purpose. So through the contracts and the dollars that we receive from there, we reinvest them into hiring more staff members that can become part of our team here at Commercial Services. Our members here are going through the same HR process that I did when I started in September. We sat in the same onboarding, and we're proud to say we pay above minimum wage. So the more contracts that we receive here at Commercial Services, the more people we are able to employ. We do currently have a waiting list of people waiting to get in, so we will. We'll reach that and keep moving forward, because we'd love to grow and grow large. Our team members choose their schedule based on their individual needs in their private life. We have people who work here 2 hours, 3 times a week, up to 5 hours, 5 days a week, based on their needs. We're really excited to be part of that, because some of them choose to make the goal of going out of their current living situation into a new one, and or with one of our individuals, we help them qualify for a mortgage for him and his family. And we're really excited about that we were able to be part of that for him. Very excited about what the future can bring, where we can grow, not just in facility, but more importantly, grow so that we can accommodate more team members with disabilities, that they can come and choose this as their place of employment. Every day you walk in, there is something new. If we ever look at our wall of inspiration here that we've got at Commercial Services, it's working with team members that share a story with you every day. We celebrate every day successes, and we talk about, you know, the future for them as well. And that's inspirational every day walking through the door. Our team members here, they're all individuals. They all have a story to share. They believe in our mission, and they help us guide in our mission and what we do both inside as a community and outside.
I was so relieved that I did have a job at Goodwill, because I had been on the job market looking for jobs and having no success. And it was just like, oh, I have a job. And then from there on, it just blossomed. My favorite part about working here is that I get to wake up in the morning and just know that I'll be able to come into work and have the sense that I'll have accomplished something by the end of the day. It's a very loving environment, and I couldn't have such a loving environment anywhere else. We all are there for each other, and we support each other. I had problems with mental health, problems with my physical health and stuff like that. When I started here, I was in a wheelchair. That was because I could not walk on my own. And slowly I was able to get out of that. I'm now using a walker. They worked around my disability. Well, with my other jobs, they didn't do that. And I was able to just grow up in who I was. And I just grew in my character, and my self-confidence just grew. And I love it.
So we're gonna check our first aid kits.
I became a health and safety ambassador. Shortly after that, I kind of discovered I'm gonna need my first aid. I went and I did it, and I took it, and it was a 2-day course, and I just aced the course and had a great time doing it. I've just been blessed having this company here for me, and it's like a family.
At the end of the day, when I walk out, I sometimes pinch myself to even see if this is real, that I can work in an environment where I am so proud to be part of a mission, proud to be part of a team that sees that mission day in and day out, that we work hard every day, absolutely inspired by our team members who guide us along that mission as well. Absolutely proud in every respect to be part of the team.
I've been working for Goodwill since 2010. Goodwill is an organization that had a great mission and vision for the future. It's a social enterprise that is really reaching for the greatness in our community, opportunities for inclusive employment in the community, and with the social enterprise backing that, I see so many possibilities of where this organization can go in the future. Very fulfilling, challenging, but very rewarding at the end of the day. We see so many successes, and that definitely is what keeps me here every day. So Power of Work is a program for individuals with disabilities. They come to be supported in finding employment. We do a really deep dive with them through a person-centered plan to come up with what their skill sets and abilities are, where their dreams and aspirations are for employment, and then we try and match those skill sets with an employer's needs in the community so that they can have a successful employment experience. Through the Career Development Center, they will go through the process of a person-centered plan to find those dreams and aspirations for employment. Then they will be assisted in researching the opportunities in the community, applying for those jobs, creating their resumes, going through workshops to prepare them for the opportunities that may be in the community for employment. And then we will have job coaching within the community at their employment site for them to build those natural supports, learn those tasks required to be hopefully independent and inclusive within their workplace. Whatever they want to put their focus on or what their employment dreams are, we help them look into whatever those possibilities are. So right now, currently, we have individuals that work in restaurants, to home care, to child care, working with the City of Edmonton, to warehouses. So all ranges of employment, that is opportunities for anybody, are also for the job seekers that come to the Power of Work program.
MICHAEL, it's a no-profit organization, and we've been so proud to have so many volunteers. Right now we have 200 active volunteers. And as well, we are honored to partners with different agency, social agency, as a Goodwill. We have three individuals, volunteers from Goodwill, and they have been with us since 2008. All of them, they contribute more than 5,000 hours. Volunteers are integral part of our organization and communities. Without volunteer help, we could not provide as good quality of life that we do to our residents.
They can learn all sorts of skills, so they may go through workshops on workplace etiquette, financial management. We also do assessments to see where their skills and abilities are, so that if they come with no experience, we can, you know, take them to one of our partners to see if we can do an assessment on some of their skills and abilities, and then be able to present that to an employer. So we will do different skill development through assessments with some of our partners and within our own operations.
We have currently three people that are associated with Goodwill, two that are directly recommended to us from Goodwill, and one that Goodwill helped get involved with us. And then we have one other individual that works for us, so we have four.
We've had quite a few individuals come through over the years, over the many years that I've been here, and a lot of these people that come through, they bring a lot of the commitment, they bring a lot of energy and enthusiasm to their job, and that's something that we really appreciate.
When I first started working here, it was a little intense at first, but as it got further more in to those days, it got a little bit easier. My life without Goodwill would be like, it would be completely different, but without them, I wouldn't have this opportunity, like just have a job during the day. I am facing, it's called absent epilepsy. It's not the grand mal seizures. I just blank out, so I just go into space. I've been feeling much better now.
Well, the big support in place is Goodwill Industries. You know, they're we're involved quite heavily with the training to offer support there, and there's always a line of communication open between us.
You know, through the years that I've been involved in dealing with special needs individuals, I found that the staff is very supportive and very happy to have them here. One is that they're very committed to the job that they're doing, and they're always here to do whatever they have to do. But they just, they're so appreciative of what they're doing and the people that they're with. And so the staff really enjoy being part of them and being part of the group and socializing and everything else.
So we have partnerships with the City of Edmonton, our Abilities at Work partnership, which has been a very successful partnership for the organization with finding great employment opportunities within the city for some of the individuals, job seekers that come to our program. We also have our partnership with our PDD, so the provincial government. And we have many partnerships with many employers all across the city.
Since Goodwill has joined the Abilities at Work partnership, they've been a true member of that team, and they've been able to make sure that anyone that's been hired through the program, they've supported really well, and they've helped make sure that retention has been sound and the supervisor has felt very supported. Goodwill are supporting people that are working through Edmonton Police that are helping to clean the police cruisers, and they also have someone that's working at one of our leisure centers in the locker room.
Kerry works out of headquarters, and he's our vehicle cleaner here. And Colin works out of Southwest Division and does the same role for them and some of the Southern Side divisions for the police. Cleaning vehicles, exterior, interior wash, wax, basically what you would get at an outside car detailer, we do in-house.
I was so excited. I was so happy. And I told my family, and they were so happy for me. And I, so when I first started, I used to work 9 to 1, and then in the brand new year, I worked my way up to 2.
I'm the employment coordinator, and what I do is specifically I deal with the clients, and I am one of the first faces they see for Goodwill. So when they come in, I do the intake with them, figure out if we're a good enough fit for them, if we have the right support. Then I get them into the program, and then I monitor them. I visit with them about 3 to 4 times a year. About every 3 months, I do a different meeting with them for progress, and then an annual to sign all their paperwork again, just to keep them in the program and make them keep going.
I have cerebral palsy, doesn't affect my work. I come here to work, I think positive, happy.
We need to put a lot more focus when they're first into a job, make sure they're comfortable and know all their safety and all that, and then know all the tasks that they need to do. But some people, you know, we're only in there for maybe a couple of weeks. Some people were only in there one day even. And then there are others that just say goodbye and we're not there at all with them because they got it the first day. Don't need us at all. And sometimes the companies, they provide excellent natural supports, so they don't even need us at all.
Well, the individuals themselves have some interesting personalities. You know, lots of them like to chat or talk and meet people. The mechanics here, as well as the sworn officers that come in and visit, have a wonderful time chatting and talking about their, you know, how things going, what you do on the weekend. You know, we all kind of step up and help each other out, getting cars for carrier for calling and bring them in.
I like working for the city of Edmonton. Makes me feel happy.
In the last year, we've had 101 individuals employed within the community with 58 employers. It makes me feel really happy that individuals are being included in their community, being part of an inclusive work environment, and that our community, our city of Edmonton, is growing in the ideas of hiring people with disabilities. The education and awareness is working within our community, and we're seeing many successes.
I've been with Goodwill for 2.5 years now. I've had some retail experience from accounting. I'm a chartered accountant by training. Retail was always something that was very interesting to me. Now to blend that with a social enterprise, or an organization that does good for the community as well too, was just the ace in the hole, I guess, to bring me to Goodwill so I can bring some of my skills and expertise on a financial background to the organization, and then also give back to the community as much as I possibly can. I've worked with corporations, and all that mattered was making money in the bottom line. And at Goodwill, we kind of have that almost the same kind of attitude. We want a healthy bottom line, but we want profit with purpose. And so our purpose is to expand our mission and help as many people out as we can. So we are a charity, we're a not-for-profit organization, but we also run a business, and we're treated like a business, and that's very important to be as efficient and effective as we can. Goodwill connected to the community is extremely important because we are in the community ourselves. All of our employees are obviously part of the community, and the community is full of people who need help, people with disabilities who need help and want help, and we're there to offer that help, and we hope that we can make sure that they get what they need. And then the other side, of course, is the environmental piece. We do a lot of recycling and repurposing of items, household items, and we think it's very important that our community is up to speed on that kind of stuff. And I think Goodwill plays a very big part of that. Goodwill's been in Alberta for over 60 years, and of course the Goodwill movement in North America has been in existence since the early 1900s, so it's always been a local piece, and that's the beauty of Goodwill and why it's so important that it is in the community, for the community, and by the community as well too, because it's the donors that help support our mission through our social enterprise, so it's just so local, right from the grassroots up.
We're always on the lookout for partnerships with other social enterprise organizations that are doing good work in the community. And when Goodwill opened its donation center, that was its sort of toehold in the community. And then when they opened the store a couple years ago, our members got involved in the grand opening, and we've started supporting the work that they've done out here because it does involve youth and it does involve people with developmental disabilities. And those are both segments of the community that we support and try and help as well. Rotary's a worldwide organization whose motto is service above self. So we're focused on things to improve the lives of people worldwide and in our communities. And so focus on health and welfare and community development and economic development, you know, being able to have people with
disabilities be employed meaningfully and gainfully is central to Rotary's mission and the mission of the Rotary Foundation.
When opportunities for partnership with a leading social enterprise like Goodwill come along, we thought it was a no-brainer to get involved. When we can help youth develop social responsibility and help others in the community, and when we can help Albertans with disabilities finding meaningful employment through partnerships like this, we're going to get involved.
We were contacted by Goodwill with the idea of putting together a mobile donation collection center, and through exploring partnerships with Driving Force and with Rotary, we were trying to get the resources to bring it together. So the idea came to us about a year ago, and we started putting the ball in motion to make it a reality. This is our first opportunity to see it in action, and it's good to see it right here in our community.
We're looking to gain more partnerships, but I think by being more out there in the community, certainly by opening stores such as the one we're standing in front here in Sherwood Park is a big part of that. We're trying to open as many donation centers in as many communities as we can as well too. So we are Alberta-wide with operations in Grand Prairie, the Capital Region, and the Calgary Region as well too. It's very important that we're there with the community and working with the community and with the individuals in the community, and it's just the general partnership between employers and persons with disabilities and our stores and donors and customers alike.
They started off as sort of a charity thing to help out people in need, but they've turned into our number one seller, so it's a good enterprise now. Oh, by far they're number one. We sell thousands of them a year. Probably the Goodwill name helps out a lot, and also they're just a good product at a good price. Well, we're a local company, so we help support local charities, and it was pretty much that was it. It started off as a small thing and grew into, like I say, the number one seller. I see expansion and maybe even different sizes. They do a great product. People wouldn't buy it again and again if it wasn't good.
Goodwill is involved in all sorts of partnerships from a employment perspective, of course, as far as our Power of Work program goes. We partner with a lot of employers to get employees experience in the workforce. Of course, we hire persons with disabilities ourselves and partner with the training programs. We partner with all sorts of employers, with recyclers, with salvage buyers. We partner with schools for donations and community centers and community leagues just to increase our donation flow. You know, the success has come from the people that we help and the smiles that we see when people get jobs that they were looking for. We've seen people get work in their first paycheck, and you know, they're in their 40s and this is the first job that they've had, and they're able to go out and buy their own Christmas presents for their family as opposed to having somebody do that for them. So that's the win, and that's really what we're all here for.
Abilities at Work is a recruitment program that we started out of the diversity recruitment team designed specifically to hire people with intellectual disabilities at the City of Edmonton. After the Abilities at Work program had been going on for a little while, we decided to expand the program, and so we got in contact with Goodwill about being one of the new partners to the program. I think one of the benefits of Goodwill working collaboratively with other partners is that it really works towards a common goal of helping not only just find jobs for people, but finding the right jobs for the right people. And when that common goal exists between different partners, it really allows them to think about working collaboratively as opposed to competitively. So they're able to kind of share best practices with each other. And as an employer, you get to see a bit of consistency among the support that's provided. So I'm able to know that no matter which area Goodwill supports, that they're going to come in and give really reliable support to them.
It's definitely a snowball effect, isn't it? It's something that just builds upon itself, and as people become more aware of what's going on and the good things that Goodwill is doing in the community, then more people will come on board and help support our mission, whether it's coming shopping at our stores or coming and donating their used household goods or helping out as if they're an employer and maybe they want to hire someone with a person with a disability. And there's just so many benefits that can happen from it, and it will just snowball as time goes on.
Well, it's a success of over a century in the making. What I'm very proud of is it's not an overnight sensation like the cell phone or the microwave oven. where instantaneously you become relevant to people. The development of a hand up, not a handout, has been a refinement, it's been fine-tuning. So it's philosophy of Kaizen is very relevant in terms of constant improvement and moving the agenda forward. Fine-tuning over time is our opportunity to ensure that, again, we're relevant with the community, we're relevant with our mission, we're serving persons with disabilities in a very dynamic way, and it takes time to do it right. Our mission is to support Albertans with disabilities to get meaningful employment, we know that, but we have sub-agendas as well, supporting and championing the environment, creating an avenue or a vehicle through people in the community wanting to affect positive change, whether that's directly for people with disabilities or just creating a greater community. There's probably been never more of a relevant time for Goodwill as a vehicle to creating great opportunities for tomorrow than the present. And that will only get more relevant going forward. Trends in society such as stewardship and championing of the environment, a whole new outlook by the community and society on persons with disabilities and moving from sympathy and charity towards empathy and excitement about opportunities for persons with disabilities. So I'm excited about the future with Goodwill because of, again, trends that are supporting why Goodwill is so relevant today, whether it's the environment, whether it's creating employment opportunities and through the dignity of a job, positively affecting lives in so many ways. Again, we've been developing our model for over 100 years. We are at 13 stores now, and there is capacity within the current communities we serve to enlarge our footprint, and we have many, many communities interested in the Goodwill model coming to their community. What's exciting is the number of communities where community leadership is requesting our presence and an opportunity to partner. There is a lot of growth opportunity here in Alberta, both in the communities we serve and those that we have yet the opportunity to serve. By evolving and growing relationship with the community, that model will assist us to get better, bigger, and greater going forward in the future. I see much more mission presence in our stores. I see career development centers embedded within our operations, throughout our operations. I see centers of excellence for career development. I see centers of excellence for recycling and repurposing. Whereas we have warehouses now, I see the future of those becoming hubs of opportunity. Hubs of opportunity that focus on recycling, green jobs for persons with disabilities, and much, much more. Goodwill is proud of its relationships with other organizations in the community, and many, many other organizations have had tremendous success like Goodwill. We are looking forward to working with those organizations. Our focus is on employment. Theirs might be on assisted living. Together, there is a package of opportunity to steward greater tomorrows for Albertans with disabilities, and collaboration will be that opportunity.
We have more.
Our excitement of working with the younger generation in the schools is they're all over social responsibility. They're excited about encouraging that every decision has a ramification. And a lot of those ramifications have to do with the environment, the betterment of fellow people in the community. So introducing Goodwill into the schools is a tremendous opportunity in both directions.
Our school got involved because we thought it was a really great way to build community and to teach the students how to give back to the community, and also to open different pathways for some of our students to be able to get involved with Goodwill. And we have a few students who are in our Knowledge Employability program who do work at the Goodwill store, and so to help give different opportunities to our students.
Well, like many things, I think that in a community, it's very important in order to achieve great success that everybody works together and helps each other out. The Goodwill drives at our school are a great way of doing just that. Not only does it strengthen our community cohesion, but also provides a fun opportunity for students and staff alike to work together and see the great things they can accomplish together.
Yeah, it's a really big event. We have a really big competition about three times a year, and it gets super covert. There's like secret teams and all that kind of stuff between the classes. And it's when it's not on for those times of the year, we always have the Goodwill bins in the lounge that we can bring people, stuff can bring people to. We've had like couches been brought in, we've had TVs been brought in. There was one time one of the classes was almost overflowing with how much stuff was being brought in.
So we also pair with Horizon Stage So when Horizon Stage runs events, they bring in a lot of donations, and then the kids can bring in stuff whenever. When we really get the enthusiasm from the students is when we do drives like we did today. And that's when we will have classes compete to see which group brings in the most amount of donations. And they really get into the sense of competition, but also into the giving back kind of atmosphere.
Thank you so much.
Our actions, as small as they can be, when joined together in a team effort, can positively impact the lives of the less fortunate in our community.
For over 100 years, Goodwill has pledged to give a hand up, not a handout. It is because of this that we have strived to assist Albertans with disabilities to gain self-respect. Across 17 countries, every year, over 130 million people are served through mission services, and over 250,000 people have found jobs with Goodwill's help. Through our Power of Work program, we've been able to enhance people's lives through helping them to secure meaningful employment. But none of this would ever be possible without your generous support. It's because of your donations that we're able to give back to the community and help people find jobs. Not to mention diverting tons of reusable goods from going into Alberta landfills. It's together with your help that we are